Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I am Bill Jell, and today's question sent in by Diane from Michigan. And boy, Diane is very specific in this. She says that she has some data names, first name, last name, that runs from G5 to G400. She wants first name in column G, last name in column H. All right, well, you know, there's a problem with this. I mean, what we're going to do is insert a couple of columns here and then select the whole data set, control shift down arrow, go to the data tab, choose text to columns. In the first step, choose delimited, second step, space, uncheck tab, and click finish. But anytime you do this, so we now have first name, last name, and then two. All right, so you always have to sort this data by these fields out here to figure out what didn't match. All right, so like here, Mary Frances Bell. Well, Mary Frances is probably the first name and Bell's the last name. Ruby Aguilar Perez, that's probably should be a hyphenated last name. Jose Graves the third, that should belong there. And I will sort these. First I sort by this one over here, A to Z. Good, there were none of those. Now sort over here, A to Z, and then I just fix those. All right, so I retype things. So anytime you use text to columns, be aware that you're going to be going through a little bit of pain. My other way is to build this with a formula. So first name and last name, and I use the find. So equal left. We want the left of that name, comma, find a space within the name. That's going to return the position where the space is, subtract one from it, and we get Wilma. Check that out. Copy it down. Works out well. And then what we need here is equal mid of that, and we want to start at the length of the first name and then just put in an impossibly large number like 50. All right, and to get rid of the leading and trailing spaces, start this with trim, closing parenthesis. Copy that down. Oh, off by one. Length of H5 plus one. There we go. Copy that down, and we're good. Still, a couple of things we want to do. We want to make sure to convert these formulas to values, of course. So, we can use on the Home tab, copy, and then paste values right there. You still want to sort this data, though, to look for any errors. So I'm going to go to data, this time sort Z to A. So right there, someone with only one name caused problems with our formula. So you want to fix those again manually. So no matter what you're going to do, you're going to have to be careful to do a couple of manual checks. And then, of course, we wanted our first name in column G, so I'll make sure to delete this. All right, so it sounds like a really easy question, but of course, as you get into this, there's a couple of, well, relatively easy approaches, both of which might have problems because of people that have either one or three or four or five names. So there you go. Diane, thanks for sending that question in. Thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.